will start on the next layer. Next layer is the our closest, greatest friend, worry and depression. Let us work on the layer of black hole. Have you heard of that phenomena? In Veda, in Rig Veda, very clearly the phenomena of black hole is mentioned. You need to understand a few things on darkness. Then we will be able to enter into the whole meditation. You see, each and every one of us, by our own nature, we have a layer of darkness around us. This body is called etheric body. The layer of darkness around our being. Then you see, whenever your energy is up, your body is ready, you feel excited, you enjoy the world, everything. Whenever your body needs a rest, automatically mind is pulled down and inserted into the etheric body. It's like a cell, when it is discharged, that cell is taken out, inserted into the recharger. The recharging time, there is a particular time for recharging. Same way, after your rounding or excitement, after your enjoyment, your mind will be automatically pulled because your body needs the rest. And it will be inserted in the etheric body, into your darkness. But you don't want to rest in the darkness. What you want to do? Continuously you want to jump around. When you fight with the darkness, when you don't want to rest in the darkness, till you get recharged, that recharging period of half an hour or 1 hour, when you fight with the darkness, you create side effects, which is called depression and worry. The depression is a natural phenomena which is supposed to happen. It is actually rest. The nature gives you the rest. Nature gives rest to your energy. If you really get depressed, you have a technique of how to really get excited. A man who can't get depressed can never get excited. Understand? If you know how to travel with the low mood, low curve, then you will know how to fly with the high mood. If you don't know how to travel with the low curve, low mood, you will never be able to go to the peak of the high mood also. Darkness is the etheric body. Darkness is the place where you get regenerated. Darkness is the layer which we are going to work. Darkness is the layer from which actually you receive energy. Why the sleeping is so refreshing? It totally refreshes your body. You are actually plucked, inserted into the etheric body, inserted into the darkness. There is a layer of darkness. It is called Karma Sarira, the etheric body. Darkness layer. Two things happens when you cooperate with the darkness. One thing, you don't resist with repression. You don't create depression at all. Depression can never depress you if you simply depress the depression. As long as you resist with it only, it is depression. When you allow it, it is a rest. It's a deep rest. It is just you are with yourself. If you don't want to be there, but you will be pulled to be in that mood, then you fight with it. Then you name it depression, worry, suffering, everything. Only when you don't want to be in that mood. Whenever you are called, whenever you are summoned, come and be there. Many times you will be summoned even in your house. You will be in the office, suddenly you have a call. Come immediately to the home. Whenever you are summoned, simply order, obey the order. Then you will not have any problem. Just know how to travel with the depression, with the darkness. Even the depression word is a very condemning word.
Can you explain it with one example?
You see, whenever you have a weekend, you just go around, enjoy everything. Everything is over. When you come to the house, or when you get up from the next day morning, your body and the mind will have the hangover. It will feel like as if it wants to rest. It doesn't want to move anywhere. It just wants to lie down and rest. Your mind doesn't want to work. But what you do? You forcibly say, let us go and enjoy something more. Something else. When you forcibly bring it out, without inserting or letting yourself in the etheric body. Etheric body is the, like a recharger. Recharger, just exactly the same philosophy. Cell getting discharged and it will be just removed and put inside for recharging. But the cell is not ready to wait even until the time it gets recharged. It just again wants to jump into the toy and play with the toy. So, when you don't let the recharging happen, when you just resist with the recharging process, then what you create is depression. If you don't resist and if you allow the process to happen for few moments, then depression will drop you. You see, once the battery is charged, it will be simply thrown out. Then you will have the total energy to have the ultimate excitement. Yes.
Is there a way to reduce those recharging periods?
It differs. The time differs for every person. Time differs for every person. But once you know the knack of how to cooperate the charging process, then the time will reduce, the quality will improve. The time will reduce, the quality will improve. So it's the knack to cooperate, the method to cooperate with the darkness. See, this is the darkness, the ultimate darkness. If you allow yourself to be recharged for a few minutes, you will come out of the depression. If you allow yourself to be recharged, if you cooperate with this darkness, you will come out of the sleep. If you totally work on the darkness, you can come out of the death, because all these three are the same expression, are same, the name of that darkness. Understand? Depression, sleep, depression, deep sleep, death. All these three things are the outcome of the same darkness layer. If you know how to work with the darkness, in the ordinary life, the depression will disappear. The lokar will be very small. In your regular life, the sleep, the quantity will reduce and the quality will become deep. The third thing, very death, the fear of death or the death experience as you think will disappear. You will not fall in coma before you die. You can consciously die. As of now, 99% of us die only falling in coma. It is the worst death you can have, falling in coma and dying. It's high pain. Don't think coma means you don't have the pain. You have the pain. From outside you don't feel the pain. Inside it will be excruciating. You see, when the pain becomes too much, you have your own inbuilt system of painkiller to make you forget the pain. That is the coma system. Coma is the inbuilt painkiller system. Am I right? You see, why do you condemn so much about the laziness? You have a very deep hatred towards laziness. If you actually stop hating the laziness will disappear from you. You see, when some guest comes to your house, if you do everything, these, that, front, back, you are running around here and there, you are preparing all the things, you do everything, will he leave? He will never. But if you just don't care at all, what will happen? Naturally, a small story. Once a Moor went to his friend's house. The friend is very cunning fellow, but diplomatic. diplomacy and cunningness goes hand in hand. You can always find the people who are innocent, they will never be diplomatic. They do not know what is diplomacy and all these things. But cunning guys, they know the diplomacy. Adivinayam durda lakshanam. There's a Sanskrit proverb. Adivinayam durda lakshanam. The cunning fellows, they know the diplomacy. That guy, he somehow wants to drive away our morgue. And that guy suddenly called his wife, bring coffee. The wife came and told, there is no sugar, no milk, nothing is in their house. Then this fellow got up and gave a good kick to her. What, you fool? You don't know how to behave, how to treat the guests. You don't have anything. What is this? This is the way to receive my friend? Is this the way to take care of him? Is this the way to treat the guests? He started shouting and beating. She started weeping and wailing. Of course, must be that lady of old age. Lady of olden time. You see, this guy started beating that guy, she started weeping. Then that moor felt, he said, no, sorry, don't worry, just because of me only all this problem, don't worry. It is time for me also, I am also supposed to go for another one function. Let me go. He just started moving towards the outside. He somehow just went out. Then this guy told, see, did I do a right drama and sent him out? She said, no. I only wept properly and sent him out. This fellow said, you see, I acted as if I have beaten you. And yes, ran away. She said, no. I acted as if I am crying. That's why he ran away. That fellow, the guy who has gone out, he came inside and started telling, you see, I acted as if I have gone, but I have come back. You beat as if you beat. She cries as if she cries. This fellow goes as if he goes and comes back. Whenever you don't take care of the guest, he simply disappears. The same way, when laziness comes, don't mind, don't too much pamper him, or don't even resist him. Just don't bother. Don't even have drop the idea that you are lazy. If it is there, let it be there. If it is not there, let it not be there. Then you will see it disappears.
So should we get up from the bed or not?
Don't get up from the bed. Don't get up from the bed, but don't continuously brood over. Physically, when you are excited, ma, your other layer energy works. Whenever your body needs the rest, but if your mind is continuing in the excited mood, your body cannot rest. You will not allow your mind to rest, your body to rest. So your mind itself will be pulled inside and inserted into the etheric layer, the darkness layer. So your mind itself will not work. Your mind itself will not be active. Unless your mind is black, your body will not be black. You will not let your body to be black. So your mind will be pulled and inserted into the black hole, the darkness layer, the etheric body layer. That is the moment. If you resist with that moments, then you think, oh, I have depression. You create depression by thinking that you have depression. If you don't resist with that moment, that you will simply go inside and come out with full energy and regenerated feeling. So it will be more like a rest than the depression.
So what if husband and wife, they have different, the body tells them, you know, at different stage, husband can do more, but wife is not able to keep up.
You see, at those times, each one should act like a mother to other. Mother to other. There's a beautiful sloka which is chanted at the time of marriage. Most of you doesn't know what you chant at the time of marriage.
Nobody knows.
That's what only purohits get married. Never the husbands. Only that guys, they put the Mangal Sutra. Never the husbands. Because these fellows don't even know that what they are chanting. And don't even understand what they are doing. There's a mantra which says, let the wife become the mother of the husband, let the husband become the father of the wife. At some moments, you need to become more like a mother, more like a father, understanding the other's problems. You see, for that you need to understand your problems. Only when you can forgive you can forgive others. Only when you accept you can accept others. Only when you understand your problems, you can understand others' problems. At those times, naturally, the other should be more like a father or the mother.